If you want to charge your phone from your electrical system, you're going to need a USB outlet or a 12-volt outlet. And that's exactly what we're going to cover today in lesson number one of this branch circuits playlist. My name is Nate, and welcome to the EXPLORIST Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Now, before we get started, there's a couple prerequisite pieces of information you need to know, like cutting wire, stripping wire, crimping terminals into wire, but we've already covered that in a specific playlist of this academy, so go back and review that if you don't already know how to do this part. And lastly, before we get started, the fuse block that we're using in this particular demo is the Blue Sea Blade Fuse Block. Now, there's several different types of fuse blocks on the market, like the Progressive Dynamics Fuse Block, the Blue Sea Safety Hub, the Tiger Expedition UFO 200, and all of those are realistically going to be connected in much the same way. They're all getting their power from a different distribution hub, like the Victron Links distributor, which is getting its power from the battery. But we're going to skip all of that side of the system and focus mainly on how we get power to the rest of the branch circuit. Let's get started. We're going to start over here at our fuse block. I have already pulled the fuse out of it, so we don't have any power coming through these wires that we are actively working on. Got our positive wire connected to this positive terminal and the negative wire connected to the negative bus bar terminals up here. Time to make our first connection. So we've got our lever nuts over here. The little lever nuts, they just have this little lever right on the front that they just flip up and allow us to put our wire in place. We'll start with our negative wire. We'll put that in place so that the stripped part of the wire is on the little bus bar connector that's right inside of there, making sure there's no interference with the insulation. And we're going to do the same with our positive wire. Flip the lever up, put the stripped wire into the lever nut, and then flip the lever back down, securing the wire in place. Now we've got to the spot where we want to put our first outlet, and we need to put on these little extensions that have a stripped wire on one side and a spade connector on the other side that will go onto the back of the outlet. Positive wire to the lever nut that's connected to the positive wire. Flip the center terminal up. It doesn't matter which one you flip up, just pick one. Same thing on the negative wire. Now with these lever nuts in place and these wires in place, we'll go ahead and make our connections to the actual outlet here. So there is a positive and negative little note on the back of these. It's really, really hard to see. I'm not even sure if y'all can see that, so you may just have to take my word for it, but they're there. So in my case, positive is on this side, so I'll take my red wire, push it onto the terminal, and the negative wire, push it onto the negative terminal there. Just like so. Now we can test it out. Put our fuse back into the fuse block, like so. Open it up. USB outlet, like that. Grab a phone. And we're charging. Silent mode, so as you can see, it's on the top there. Okay, this works great. So this is how you would connect a single USB outlet. Before we move on to connecting the second USB outlet, it's important to note that these lever nuts, they're not 100% necessary. It's more of a convenience thing as far as I'm concerned. You could crimp your spade connectors onto the ends of these wires here and just go right to the back of the outlet. It's more of a personal preference here, but I like putting these on so that I have pretty much unlimited flexibility with adding additional outlets or circuits or anything like that without any other considerations really. So more of a personal preference here, so just do with that what you will. So let's move on to connecting the second outlet. We're going to go ahead and assume that the second outlet is going to be placed, you know, a fair ways further away from the first outlet. So we've got some longer wires that we've got stripped ends on there. And we'll take the black wire here. Connect that into our negative lever nut here. Same thing on the positive wire. Like so. And then our long wires here, we'll go to our second location with another lever nut. Oh, I'm being dangerous here, working with live circuits. Let's disconnect that fuse. Okay, and our second location wires are prepped. We've got our lever nuts there, positive to positive, negative to negative, just like we did on our first one, with spade connectors on the ends of those wires. That we're then going to look on the back of our outlet there to see which one's positive, which one's negative. This side is the negative in this case. Always good to look at the notes though on the back. And we are good to go. So this is how you would do USB outlets or 12 volt outlets in two separate locations. So it's worth noting that right here, I actually kind of cheated a little bit because I've got a 12 volt outlet, because the wiring for a 12 volt outlet and a USB outlet are realistically the exact same methods. You may just use bigger wire sizes for 12 volt outlets, but all that's going to be determined by the load calculations that you do when you do the circuit, but this video is just focusing on how to make the actual physical connections. So that is how you do that. If you wanted to add more, you would just keep repeating that all the way down the circuit until you're finished. Why do people need this? Let's see.
Why do you
If you want to charge your phone,